Okay, well, the bullshit continues. Here it is into February, like the 11th. Last night, I always park, at least the past few months since they closed off Topanga. I've been parking, I had to get away from the lunatics over there. I've been parking over here, overnight in front of this American Apparel store, which, if you look down the road there toward Malibu, the Malibu city limits is a good 300 yards down the street from the American Apparel. The signs for the parking restriction stop right there in front of my Lincoln. See that? So there's no restriction overnight. And you can notice all the way down the road, all the people in Malibu park openly right in front of their houses, and they're on the, you know, they're on the berm. They're not like in a driveway. They're all right up on the side of the road. And on the other side of the road, there's thousands of cars parked. There's no parking restriction except for overnight camping. What does that mean? Camping? Or, you know, sleeping in your car. You can't stop and just sleep in your car in America anymore. You can go into Los Angeles, you can sleep on the sidewalk, believe it or not. There was a court case that says, oh yeah, if you're a human being, you can sleep on the fucking sidewalk. But don't you dare sleep in a car or in a vehicle like this. So last night, for the second time in months, right out here in front of the American Apparel store with their child porn advertising, I get this banging on the windows, you know, and it's about midnight. I get this banging on the windows with a flashlight, and I mean he's hitting the windows all the way around the vehicle hard enough to have cracked them. And then he's banging on the door and he's screaming, and he starts screaming. He says, "Sheriff's Department, open the door! Open the door!" I didn't even answer, you know. And what if I hadn't have been there? You can't open it. There's nobody in there, and you don't open the door. So, the worst thing is he starts trying the door, which is a total violation. He starts doing this. Of course, it's locked, but he's doing this. He's trying to pull the door open. Then he goes around and he tries to open the driver's door. And I had an alarm set, and the alarm starts blipping. And he goes away because I can hear him. I can tell he's pissed. Then he's going around shining his flashlight inside. Then he comes back a few minutes later and he puts this. And this is the first time I've read this. But look at this. Vehicles parked on the street 72 or more consecutive hours may be removed. It says, the make of the vehicle, sunbeam, Ramirez. Now, I wasn't parked there 3 days. That tells me either this guy's got a hard-on for me, or he's just been assigned, or I recognize that name. This is the same son of a bitch that did this almost a year ago and started the whole cop war out here. The same son of a bitch, Ramirez. Or maybe, you know, who knows? I might as well be in Tijuana with these, you know, these names. But I'm thinking, up here on top of the American Apparel store, there's a some kind of phony baloney foundation where they, you know, they get money from rich people, and all these trendy yuppies come out here once or twice. They park up and down. You know, they're illegally parked here, too, all night. You know, after 10, they don't get tickets. They go up there, and they drink, and they have a party. And then they come down, and there were still a bunch of them in the parking lot over here. Almost up, you know, up to midnight and after midnight. So they see me sitting there, whereas nobody is usually there. After 10, when do they close? They close at like 8 o'clock. All right, so there's nobody there after like 8 p.m. So it doesn't matter if somebody's parked there. I'm not in front of any houses. They're all the way down there. They're another, you know, they're like I said, 200 yards down by the Malibu. There it is. See the Malibu sign down there? Malibu city limits. So this cop, either one of these yuppies calls and complains. That's usually where it starts. Because they don't like the look of my coach. They don't like my coach. Well, that's too bad. Or, you know, because these idiots. They don't understand what's going on in this country. You know, so what they're going to do is they're going to start blaming poor people for all of their problems. And that's usually where it starts, with this nonsense. Or this Ramirez piece of shit took it upon himself to hand me an illegal warning, knowing full well I was not there 3 days in a row. This thing moves every single day, all right, legally. And it also, I'm gonna have to put the warnings back in the window. But look at this. This has probably made him crazy. A picture of a dumb cow stuck on a fence. And underneath it, the caption says, "She didn't question authority." See, if you take illegal orders from an authority figure, you know, a steroidal, shaved head, little guy named Ramirez, who's banging on your door, trying to open your door, hands on gun belts, you know, heavy flashlights in their hand, ready to hit you. I'm going to have a word with this Ramirez, because these things are illegal. Not that they're, you know, if somebody had a car sitting there for weeks, that'd be a different story. But, hey, there's hundreds of them up in Malibu that never move. But they call it a violation. A warning notification. Your vehicle's parked in violation of a state or local ordinance. Well, that's not true. 72 hours, you know. They don't put these on the yuppie cars. Here I was, just when I thought I was out, they keep pulling me back in.